Chips the puck free. Lafferty back to pick it up. Flips it out. Gloved by Ben. Miller doesn't want to touch it. It'll be a hand pass.
He touched it.
I don't know what the rules are.
I don't know what the rules are.
Okay, you touch it. And they're trying to bang the Canucks stick against the puck.
One of the more thrilling moments of the season.
Going end to end, Jacob Slavin on Matt Grizzlick. The backhand scores! It found a hole between Halak and the post. Jacob Slavin.
That might have went through the net. That might have went through the side of the net. Couldn't believe that puck actually went in. When you looked at the back and you say, wait a second, that's left of the post by a wide margin. Ah, yeah, no question.
Right through the apron. That is wacky.
After review, the puck didn't enter the net. It went through the netting. No goal.
Wow.
Oh, there's the hole. There's a broken knot. The weak link.
Amazing. That does not happen very often.
Throws it over to Cody Ceci. Left it for Patan. Nick Patan with a shot. Bounce. Rebound. Scores.
That's it.
Kapanen will bang it home.
It's in.
It is in.
In and out. I don't think anybody saw it, but the goal light went on.
That's Barry Kapanen with his sixth career goal against the Red Bulls.
Hang on, now they're saying it never went in. It may not have gone in, but from my angle, I thought it was in. Maybe Bernier got a piece of this off this glove. Watch this. Off the glove. Oh, what a save. What a save by Bernier.
It sure looked like it was in, and the red light went on. What another great stop by Bernier. Oh, boy.
Was flipped in over the line again by Eichel. Dropped it back. Mott with this. A shot. And he scores. Wow, I didn't know it went into the net at the end. I couldn't see it.
I think the goalie feels the same way.
He just hammered it, and it seemed to disappear.
I didn't see that go in.
There was no celebration from the Sabres initially either.
I don't know if they knew it went in.
The light didn't go on. The crowd didn't cheer. Siren didn't go. You talk about burying a puck. It was buried in the back by that plastic. No one could see it.
Vrana splitting two. Vrana fires, and a glove save for Vasilevsky. Or is that it?
It's it.
Oh, yeah, count it. Vrana was slow to respond. Palms up, he says it was in the whole time. It's 3-2.
Vrana shoots, save Vasilevsky, and he holds on. Well, that was an instance where the Lightning were very sloppy in the neutral zone. Oh, they're saying it's in.
Vrana scores, a late reaction, but they said that puck went in.
Apparently only Vrana and Vasilevsky knew that it was in.
Hit man the puck, here's Hartman. And the rebound in front, gets it down, and stays out. What a close call that was.
How did that stay out? Nielsen with the initial save, the second, and then watch Hartman. He's got an open net. He actually hits this right there and pops it off the goal line out the other way.
Getzloff, and a good read by Holtby, who comes firing out of his crease. Very nearly put it in his own net. Wow.
I've seen a lot of things. I've never seen a goaltender put it in his own net, and by a matter of inches, I still haven't.
That would have made every blooper reel for 100 years if that had gone in. And it missed by about an inch and a half. Oh, man.
Good defensive play by Hiroshi. Muzzin dropped the glove. Wasn't on right. Dropped the glove and still got a shot away. That was interesting.
It's not easy to do when you've got your bare hands on the stick. Not sure why he dropped that glove. Something not right about it. One of the finger holes was plugged up or something. That is funny.
I'm not quite sure why what happened here. Oh, he gets called down, and then the puck will come back to him. And I guess he never really got his glove on properly, so let's just get rid of that, and I'll shoot it anyway. Don't know that I've ever seen that.
No.
Welcome back to the St. Paul Civic Center, where they might go shopping for a new blimp on Black Friday. A little difficulty with
look like me driving that thing. I don't fly any of these things. Boy, they had a tough time. Maybe fire a puck off of that and help that process along. Or, you know, a malfunction brought out the extended ladder, and they're able to sort it out. But whoever's driving has to hand over the controls now.
It's my favorite rock group, Led Zeppelin.
And Cassian dumps himself into his own bench as he tried to lay out Ian Cole.
Change.
Wow. Watch this. Zach Cassian. I meant to do that. We'll be back.
Mike Green put it to the Washington bench. Drilled into the Washington bench by Hathaway.
Oh, my. What a slam into the Washington bench.
Absolutely no help for the former Washington Capitals by the boys in white.
Up top, Hedman a shot wide of Reimer, the rebound. And a front goal. Oh, Reimer. My goodness.
outstanding reaction, kicking that one out of play.
Talk about a little unorthodox. He's spinning around. He's facing the wrong way. And he just lifts his leg up in the air and boots it into the crowd. Oh, my goodness. When you're in the zone, you can do things like that.
Like a member of Cirque du Soleil.
Now we've got Christine Simpson standing by downstairs with a special guest that's enjoying the day. Chris, are you there? We got some trouble in the truck. Are we on the air? Oh my goodness. It's the master of mayhem himself, the menacing monster, the bushy bully of Broad Street. I can't believe it. Gritty has taken over the truck. Where's Tommy Lasorda? We need a mascot ejection here.
Nugent Hopkins, McDavid down deep. He'll walk right out in front, off the pad of Reimer. He'll cover up with Pesci going down in the crease.
And the referees are getting together, I'm sure, to detect whether or not Brett Pesci covered this puck with his hand in the crease, in which case it would be a penalty shot. I think he did.
Oh, boy.
He does.
Ward, a penalty shot for 22, covering the puck in the crease.
Yeah, they got it right. James Reimer, who's been a big-time story, will be tested here.
And it will be Connor McDavid taking the penalty shot.
Rogers Place fans rise as McDavid moves in against James Reimer. McDavid bobbled the puck, and that eliminates the play.
Wow, what were the odds of that? Still fresh ice, less than 2 minutes into the second period. Okay, John. Is there a full moon outside?
I don't know.
You just don't see that.
Great reaction from Brett Pesci.
4:45 left to go here in the third period.
Oh!
Long shot just inside center, and Hamilton finds the back of the net.
Koskinen fooled on a red line dump in by Dougie Hamilton. My goodness.
Watch where Dougie Hamilton is looking. He's looking like a dump in, and Mikko Koskinen bites on it. Takes a quick look over there. Looks like he's shooting one way, shoots it the other way. Real clever play by Dougie Hamilton.
Up on the wing, racing after a Cherry. Cherry took a shot, they score!
Oh, how did it go in? The Sabres are up four.
It goes in, oh my goodness gracious.
Oh my, poor Louis Domingue.
You see even Connor Cherry is kind of in stunned disbelief that this puck went in, but that is the way it has gone for this Devils team.
Boy, oh boy, when things are going bad, huh?
I know that Leaf fans right now are hoping for that to happen.
Now Dermott, a long shot, Hart got a glove on it, and it scores!
There you go.
Bounces high in the air and in, and the game is tied at one.
It pops back to Dermott, he just wrists that in. It hits the right shoulder of Carter Hart and goes straight up in the air. He has no idea where that puck is after. You can actually see him shrug his shoulders. It drops right down and rolls over the line, and the Toronto Maple Leafs have tied this game at one.
Trying to find Frost, that was tipped away by Pajot and sent down the ice by Borowiecki. Now stolen by Duclair. Robert Trey scores! Anthony Duclair with a brilliant effort, shorthanded, ties the game at two.
What happened here? And they score! Gostisbehere and Hart got their signals crossed. Duclair scores.
Wow, what a turn of events here.
The Jets have it with a trailer. It's Morrissey and a shot blockered off of Hudobin and then into the net off of Janmark. It has been that type of evening.
Oh, yeah, it's forks after soup in this one.
How about the luck? Oh, goodness. A lot of things have to go right for this goal to go in, or depending on what team you are, a lot of things have to go wrong.
Spezza again, winding and shooting, and the stick disintegrates, and it's played to the line. Just kept in by Riley, but stolen now. Here's a chance for Nikushkin. He's in on a breakaway and scores! Jason Spezza broke his stick and then got tangled up with Morgan Riley trying to kick the puck in.
The strange play at the blue line, Spezza ran right into Morgan Riley. The Leafs set a pick for themselves.
And the comedy of errors turns into a shorthanded goal for Colorado.
Tries the soft toss to Strome. Corrali to Wagner. Gustafson blows a tire. Wagner scores!
Eric Gustafson went for a tumble. That gave Wagner a shorthanded breakaway.
Gustafson lost his footing at the blue line. He fell down. Wagner goes in all alone.
Gets it to Dreisaitl. Dreisaitl takes his time, feeds it through, and they score! Went in off Doughty. The Oilers on top by one.
That was meant for Chiasson, I believe, but it goes off the skate of Doughty. Continue to funnel pucks to the net, and eventually one goes off Doughty and into the back of the net.
Stamkos. Now Adele waiting, and that puck does enter the trapezoid. It's stolen. Here's Stamkos across. He scores! Johnson, tic-tac-toe with Verhaeghe and Stamkos. 5-0.
Dell gets his pocket picked here. He's a little too slow. The forecheck there is outstanding.
Up against Coleman. Into the circle, centering pass, and Rene falls down, and it gets by him. Unbelievable.
Travis Zajac makes it a 2-2 game.
Crazy stuff happening. I don't know if Pekka Rinne, if does it hit something? No, he's off balance. He would look like me if I tried to play now, man. He went up in the air, down on his butt, puck went through his legs, but we are all tied at two.
Off the blade of Nash. Nash digs it loose, gets his own rebound, and scores from below the goal line.
Braden Holtby off that post, just enough for him to throw the puck between the post and the leg.
Got to try to sneak it in there sometimes like that, and it doesn't work very often. At least it creates something, and that one created exactly what they wanted.
Petrie curls back at his goal, whips, the score by Marchand. Petrie just lost control of the puck.
And that is a bit of a dagger to end this period.
Just a clean fan by Jeff Petrie.
When it rains, it pours, and when you make a mistake, it ends up costing you.
That is tough for the Montreal Canadiens.
Now the puck loose in behind the net. Kicks out in front to Stone, and it scores! That puck found Mark Stone, and he found the back of the net.
It may have been kicked by Pacioretty over to Stone.
The puck is going to come to him, and he's just going to kick it over right there to Mark Stone.
Our producer Tim Paps has gone into the video vault, and Darren Pang is a player. Once did an interview with Dale Talon, who was a broadcaster here. And yes, you were goofy then, and you're crazy now. How's that?
Oh my goodness, that's unbelievable.
You like that?
I was the third goalie for the playoffs, and they ran out of guys to interview because they were going through the third overtime, and Dale Talon said, why don't we do something? And first thing he did, he knocked me over the head with a microphone thinking I was taller than what I was. That's good stuff. I had hair back then, too.
You had a lot of hair.
And the number one star of tonight's game, number 71, Nick Foligno.
Oh, he's going to ingratiate himself to the fans. He's got the Buckeye helmet. Big game tomorrow against Michigan. Atta boy. Yeah, go Bucks.
Here's Ovi, the old blowtorch and the helmet.
Is he doing a creme brulee? What's going on?
It's usually the stick you do that, but I guess he's woven his face shield around his helmet there. That's dangerous.
He has a future as a pastry chef.
Allmark out to play, and he'll whip it up the boards. Not out.
Matthew Tkachuk has a word with the referee. That's Steve Kozar. You got knocked down on that activity on the far side.
And of course, it's accidental.
You gotta love this.
Lori Estefan?
Yeah, the Svechnikov, the conga line.
These guys alive when Lori Estefan was making it happen on Miami Beach.
Here's Riley Smith with a break. All alone to the net. Backhand score! Riley Smith has made it 3-0.
Breaking in, Brendan Smith to the net. He fakes. He scores! Brendan Smith ends up playing. He ties it at one.
There's the goals by the Smith brothers. How about that for looking identical, right?
Right.
One known to be more of an offensive player.
Quinn Hughes, JT Miller shoots, scores! You can see Elias Pettersson pointing to JT Miller, and that's where the puck goes and explodes the water bottle. That's always a good sign.
You see the top of the water bottle come flying right off, just to put an exclamation mark on it. Come out!
Gatorade goes to Sean Monahan after that goal. It's back on the bench for the Flames.
Can you describe the goal you scored tonight?
I don't even know. Blacked out.
Is that your first wraparound goal?
Since I played NHL 95, probably.
A wet Willie with the glove on. Zucker on Nino. And Nino's probably like about to snap, and then he recognizes it's a former teammate and good friend. He says, all right.